A sad day in Lakerland, as you know, and really all of basketball. The passing of the legendary Elgin Baylor. First and foremost, Big Game, I just want to get your thoughts.
Yeah, Elgin Baylor was Mr. Laker before anybody, before Jerry West, before Wilt Chamberlain came from Minnesota. And I heard from a story from Chick Hearn that the only reason that the owner decided to make the decision to come to Los Angeles, he would only come if Elgin Baylor was coming. I think Elgin Baylor was thinking about retiring. You know, he was in the military as a reserve at the time, going back and forth. And so he was the beginning. And, you know, he was before Michael Jordan. He was Air Baylor. He was the one that innovated a lot of the game, including the jump shot. There was a lot of set shots back in the day. But he was the best small forward, you know, ever to play for a Laker. I woke up to a news article one day that said James Worthy is the second best small forward. And I was like, well, who's number one? And when I knew it was Elgin Baylor, I said, oh, that's pretty cool to be behind him. But all his accolades as a great player, if you knew him, he was a true gentleman. And that's one of the things I always remember about him. He was a true gentleman, extremely nice, and always humble.
Big Game, I love those stories. They're priceless. They're endless. Certainly just being with you night in and night out here in the studio, you always would light up when talking about Elgin. Just from your time growing up as a kid, falling in love with the game yourself, I know you watched the highlights of him. I mean, you just described him as a player to a T, but what stood out to you about him, the basketball player?
His dominance. A very shy, introverted man off the court, but a true assassin on the court. And I get these stories from Jerry West and Chick Hearn. Chick Hearn believes that nobody, including, you know, Kobe or, you know, LeBron and Magic, nobody could touch Elgin Baylor. But he played a style of the way the game is played today. He dunked on people. Like I said, he elevated on his jump shot. He glided through the air. So those are the things that I got to watch. And then meeting him, you never thought he had that kind of dominance, a very soft-spoken man. At his statue ceremony, he had his late friend, Bill Withers, the great songwriter, speak. And one of the things that I could just see was that Elgin would have people over for dinner. And then when dinner was done, he would wash the dishes. Like, that's something he's done his whole life. Right after his wife served the food, he would be in there washing dishes with an apron on. And he was just a great example of what athletes should be like. They should be a person first. Mm-hmm. Like, you know, sports is what he did for a living, but it really wasn't who he was. And so those are the great, you know, memories and times that I've had to talk to Elgin that I'll always remember. He's a Laker great, the Laker great.
And that's why I want to make a transition here with you, Big Game, because as much as we're reading and reminiscing, you know, about who he was as a basketball player, you're just touching on it so well right now, is because in a time when we are all fighting for change, for the greater good for our country, Big Game, you think of what Elgin stood for off the court, his service for our country, recognizing the need for change decades ago. How do you think he should be remembered?
He should be remembered as, one of the pioneers that, had he not had the attitude that he had back in the 50s and the 60s, being a black athlete, who knows what would have lay ahead for us? Because he said, black players can do this. They can adapt. They're smart. You know, they're conscious. And because of guys like him, he laid the path for all of us, as did Jackie Robinson and Muhammad Ali. I look at Elgin Baylor as one of those is one of those pioneers who came along and made things possible. And I think, Allie, he may have played for maybe $15,000 to $20,000 a year at the beginning. And then I think he got a big contract. And don't quote me on this. We have to get Brez to look this up. But I think he got one of the biggest contracts at about $95,000 to $100,000. These guys had part-time jobs in the offseason. So for what he went through and what he, you know, stood for, and now we're all reaping the benefits of his work and a lot of others. But Elgin was a class act, man. He was just a gentle human being.
A true pioneer, as you said. Big Game, we always love getting your thoughts. And thank you always for your time. We're thinking
you
of you and all of Laker Nation especially much.
You got it.